Page 183. Today's the first lesson that involves permutations. Permutations are rearrangements or arrangements of objects where there is a specific order. The order is, in fact, very important. The order matters. Okay? So I'm just going to write that here. Order matters. And the example that they've given us here. How many objects are we arranging? Looks like A, B, and C. And how many objects are we arranging? Three, right? So you could think of this as like a set of elements at A, B, C. These are the three objects that we have available to us. So three distinct objects. And I'm going to use that word distinct. The notes use the word different. So I'm just going to highlight that. It's the same thing. So different, distinct. To do a permutation, those objects have to be distinct. Okay, so let's take a look at the chart. How do they start us off? What's the first two letters in the first two permutations? A and A. So, okay, it goes B and then C. Okay, well, what if it started with A and then went C and then B? And that's as most as you could ever have with A in the beginning. Okay, well, let's try B in the beginning. So then what are our choices? A, then C, then A. Okay, well, let's try C in the beginning. A, then B, and then B, then A. And altogether, there's six total arrangements. And we did this yesterday, I believe, with the word cat. Do you remember the word cat? Yeah, so I've done this before with you guys. Okay, so I'm going to use a color to explain this. These three positions, these three columns, how does that relate to our fundamental counting principle that we learned yesterday and the day before that? The fundamental counting principle says that in order to spell a three-letter word, how many slots would you have to fill? Three. So each one of these positions are like the three tasks that you have to fill. So there's one, two, three underlined blanks. Now in the black ink, how many letters do we have to choose from? Well, there's three objects in our pool. I like to say that, like, there's three in our pool to pick from. So I would have three choices for that first blank. Once I use a choice, how many do I have now? Two, and then once I use a blank or use a letter, now I only have one left. And we know that 3 times 2 times 1 is also 6. Today's lesson is going to give us another way of solving these problems. And it's this notation here. This permutation has the notation NPR. So N is in the subscript. You draw like a large capital P. And then R goes in the subscript on the next spot, but I'm going to color that one in red. Why is that one colored in red? Because the R are like the slots to be filled. See the underlined blanks? The tasks, the positions, those are in red. That's the R value in this NPR notation. Talk about that formula in a bit. I want you to compare the top chart to the bottom chart. What's different about this chart to the last chart? There's only two positions. So how many blanks would you have? Just two. It's still the same objects available, A, B, and C. So how would you fill these two blanks? The first blank, you'd have how many choices? Three, and then you use a letter. Now how many choices do you have? Two. So you still get the same amount. It's still six. but it just looks slightly different. How would we write this one with our permutation notation? It would be 3, big capital P, and then a little 2, which I'll color in red to help you remember that. The second number is the positions that you have to fill, where the first number is how many objects you have. And I'll just go back to this now. So right here, we could say, okay, NPR is N objects R at a time. And I'll use my pointer now. So you have N objects, and they have to be different. They have to be distinct, or else you can't do this. So N objects that are different, where R of them are to be used in the arrangement. Okay, so let's keep going. I want to talk about the bottom here. Do you guys remember the question about the multiple choice possibilities? So it's like, okay, you have the choice of A, B, and C, and D for a multiple choice question. This was on quiz number one. Do you guys remember this? It's question number two on quiz number one. You could look at it if you want. But it was like, okay, well, how many choices do you have for question one? Well 4, right? Because it's A, B, C, or D. Well, how many choices do you have for question two? Still A, B, C, and D, so 4. And question three, it's still 4. And you do this 8 times. Do you guys remember this question? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then it ends up becoming 4 to the power 8. This is not a permutation. And the reason it's not a permutation is because repetition is allowed. For the permutations, what have we noticed every single time with the permutations? It goes 3, and then 2, and then 1. Once you use an object, you're no longer allowed to use it. 3 and then 2. Whereas with this multiple choice question, it was like, okay, 4 and then 4 and then 4. You can repeat it. It's okay. So this one's not a permutation. And to solve it, it's always going to be n to the power r, where n is the number of objects that you have to pick from, and r are the number of blanks. Now, this one here in the yellow. NPN is N factorial. Let's think of the word cat. How many letters are there? 3. If I want to use 3 blanks, then it would be 3, 2, 1, correct? That's going to be the same as 3 factorial. That's going to be the same as 3P3. If you have n distinct objects and you're going to permutate them n at a time, it's just n factorial. So anytime you have the same subscript, like 3P3 or 4P4 or 5P5, it's just the 5 factorial, 3, whatever. It's the same number factorial. Let's do a couple questions that show that. I'll come back to this stuff. Let's go down to, oh yeah, they have cat here. Let's do cat. So n different elements taken n at a time, we know that this will be n factorial. So for cat, it's going to be 3 factorial. We know it's 6. We know it's 3 times 2 times 1. Could we list all the arrangements of cat? For sure we could. Let's just start with C. If it went AT, it would have to go TA. And that's all you can do if you start with C. Okay, let's start with A. What would go next? CT or TC. Good, let's not start with A, let's start with T. So AC, then CA. That's all you'll ever get. Those are the 6 possibilities. Today's lesson is going to show you that it's the same as this notation, 3P3. All right, let's learn how to do that on the calculator. We go, you have to hit the number 3. So hit 3, and then you hit math. And then you have to go over to the probability tab. I usually just hit left once, and then you get over to the probability tab. So do this with me. Grab your calculator. And then you're in this probability tab. And then I think it's number 2. Is it number 2? Number 2. And then it'll show up on your screen, and then you're going to want to hit 3 after that. So make sure you know how to type this in the calculator, 3P3. Make sure you know how to get 6 to show up. Cole, you can get 6 to show up on your calculator? Oh, you better find one. 3P3. Okay. So, Regina. How many letters in the word Regina? 6 distinct objects. How do you know they're distinct? They're all different, right? So you always ask yourself this, are the letters different? Yes, they're all different. So what's the answer? 6 factorial. I think 6 factorial is 720. Now, is there another way we could write this? 6 objects permutating 6 at a time. This is also 720. There's 2 ways to write it. Either way is fine. Now let me show you how to use that formula. So that formula is on the back page. This one here. Let me show you how to use this formula. So if you look at this formula, what goes in the top? The left subscript, factorial. What goes in the bottom? The difference in the 2 subscripts. So n take away r in a bracket. You do that first, then factorial. So let's go back to Regina. What would this formula 6P6 give us? What goes in the top? 6 factorial over, what's 6 take away 6 in a bracket factorial? 0 factorial, right? Now I know this in the red has to be this. So therefore, 0 factorial is 1. Because you would have to divide by 1 to get 720. It's the same value. So by definition, 0 factorial is 1. So we are just learning this, so I'm doing these questions like in a variety of ways. But in general, like later when you get better at this, and you're given questions of different types all at once, if you see this word like Kelowna, you just ask yourself, are the letters all different? And how many are there? 7? So what's the answer? 7 factorial. That's it. 7 different objects. I wanna arrange all of them, so 7 blanks. 7p7 is 7 factorial. This one's 50-40. After a while, you sort of get these memorized. Okay, 10-team basketball league, and each team plays every other team twice. How many distinct objects do we have? There's 10 teams, right? N is 10. You're going to play every other team twice. Once at home, once away. How many slots to fill? Once at home, once away. How many games is that? 2. R is 2. I'm just going to go really back to the very beginning, the very first sentence. A permutation is an arrangement of objects, in this case teams, in a definite order. Is a home game different than an away game? The order matters. N, P, 2. It's 90, right? Next one. How many numbers can be made from the digits 2, 3, 4, and 5 if no digit can be repeated? So, 4-digit numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you agree that that's a 4-digit number? And how many objects do we have to fill? 4. So N is 4. How many choices do you have for the first blank? And then you use a letter or use a number. Now how many do you have? 3, and then 2, and then 1. So that's 4-digit numbers. Are we only limited to 4-digit numbers? It says how many numbers could you come up with? Up to a maximum of 4 digits. So could we do 3-digit numbers? How many blanks would you fill on this one? Just 3, right? So how many choices do you have here for the first blank? 4. And then once you use one, 3. And then once you use one, then 2. Or 2 digits. How many choices do you have for this one? First blank. 4. Once you use one, there's only 3 choices. And then last but not least is the single digit. 1-digit. How many choices do you have for the single digit? 4 choices. Now think back to set theory. What did OR mean? Do you remember what the or meant? All of it, right? So you can come, so it's that set, plus that's, so this is plus. Now I'm not gonna get the answer yet, I'm gonna do a different notation. 4p4 plus 4p3 plus 4p2 plus 4p1. So why do I have 4 here on this, and why 3, and then why 2, and then why 1? Because that's the number of blanks that are available. So what's this? 24 plus 24 plus 12 plus 4? 48 plus 12? 60 plus 4, 64? That's a tough question. This is very challenging, actually. It's quite challenging. Now, the next set of questions with golden chapters, wealth, and value. Hopefully, you're able to do this now. I want to use fundamental counting principle first. Do you see how we're only using two letters from the word golden? So how many underlined blanks? Two. The next one has three letters, so how many underlined blanks? The next one. And the last one. Now how many letters in the word golden? So your first option is six. Once you've used the letter, then it's five. How many letters in chapters? Eight. So eight, and then seven, and then six. Wealth has six, and then five, and then four, and then three. And then value has how many options? Five. Could we write these with permutation notation? What would the first one be? Six. Permutate two, yeah, two underlined blanks, right? What's the next one going to be? Eight, permutate three, because there's three blanks. The next one, six, permutate four. And then the last one is five, permutate one. Now, how does this connect to the stuff we did yesterday? Let's use the formula on 6p2. What's the top number? 6 factorial. What's the bottom number? 6 takeaway 2 factorial. What's 6 takeaway 2? 4 factorial. Here, I'll write the formula on the board just so that you remember what I'm talking about. It's n factorial on top of n minus r factorial. So you guys okay with how it's 6 on the top? And then 6 takeaway 2 is 4 on the bottom? Do you guys remember expanding these and canceling them yesterday? So it goes 6 and then 5 and then 4. Oh, stop at 4 because it matches. Those cancel and it's just 6 times 5. Just like we had with the fundamental counting. See how it's the exact same? There's lots of ways to do these problems, and you're going to want to probably just select one way that you're good at, but understand that there's multiple approaches. How would this next one look? What goes on top? 8 factorial. What goes on the bottom? 8 minus 3 is 5 factorial. Start with the 8, 8, and then 7, and then 6, and then 5. Oh, stop right there. Throw on the brakes, because it cancels the bottom. 8, 7, and 6, I don't know what that is. Could someone do that one for me? 336. Okay, 6p4, what goes in the top? 6 factorial, what goes in the bottom? 2 factorial, oh great, I got so much to cancel. 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2, stop it at 2. Oh, it's the exact same as my fundamental counting. The last one's the most annoying. 5 factorial on top of 4 factorial. Oh, actually, this one's quite nice. 5 times 4. Oh, just stop it right at 4. That one was actually the nice one. Done. Done at 5. Alright, so you have to understand that, like, on my exam, for the most part, you're just multiple choice numeric. That's what it is. You don't really have to show this kind of work. You can use your calculator. So if you were asked to take the letters from the word chapters and just do 3 at a time, all you'd have to type in the calculator is AP3, you're done. You don't have to do all this, right? But it's just the big first lesson, so I'm showing you everything and how it's all connected. The other thing I want to talk to you about is, if you know how to rearrange letters in a word, you could do any problem. Because what if this was like people lining up for a picture, and you're trying to, like, how many different arrangements for your picture? Okay, Jeff could be on the left, Olaf could be on the right, Lenny could be in the middle, Derek could be upside down, Eric could be, you know, back at home, and Ned, Ned's, you know, not even around. So what I'm saying is, you could give a letter to represent anything and then just rearrange letters. If you know how to rearrange letters, you could do any problem. So let's take a look at this next problem. The example isn't clear, but there are 3 red cars, 4 black cars, and they are all different. The example's not exactly clear. So how could you represent 3 red cars that are different? Maybe one of them's a Civic, maybe one of them's a Prelude, and the other one's a Odyssey, a minivan. How could you represent the 3 red cars? Well, you could say R1, R2, and R3. Later, we'll talk about maybe there's 3 red cars, but they're all the same. They're all red Civics, 2017 red Civic. They're all the same. How would you represent that one? R, because they're all the same. But if they're different, R1, R2, R3. How would you represent the 4 different black cars? B1, B2, B3, and B4. Now let's read the question. The 3 red cars must be parked so that there's a red car at each end, and the 3rd red car is in the middle. How many ways can the 7 cars be parked? So you're rearranging cars. But really, if you give a letter to these cars, you're just rearranging letters. Fundamental counting principle. What needs to go on the ends? Red. Red, and what goes in the middle? Red. Maybe I'll switch these to red. And then what goes in between, obviously? The blacks. Now, let's go through it. How many red cars are available to choose from? So let's put a 3 here. You have 3 choices for that spot. Once you've used a car there, you have two choices for this spot. Once you use that up, you only have one choice left. Okay, now in between, you have to fill in the black cards, so you have four choices, and then three choices, and then two choices, and then one choice. Now in multiplication, it's all multiplication, we know that. Does it matter the order that you multiply these in? So I'm just going to rearrange it so you get the four all lined up next to each other, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then the 3, 2, 1 all lined up next to each other. Alright. The answer to this is 24 times 6, whatever that is. What is it? 144? Okay, next one. The three red cars must be parked side by side. I'm just going to change that word to together. I have this question on my exam. The key word that you're going to want to look for is together. Okay, so the three red cars must be parked together. Could you just maybe give me one example of what that looks like? All the three cars parked together. Could you give me one example where the three cars are parked together? Yeah, it'd be like red, red, red. And then what would have to go next? Black, 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 black. But here's the question. Does it have to go 1, 2, 3? Could it go 3, 2, 1? Could it go 2, 3, 1? 1, 3, 2? Yeah, so the doesn't matter what order the R's go in, but they have to be together. Here's another question for you. Do they have to be in the front? What if they're like shifted over? Maybe it's like red 2, red, red 3, red 1, and then maybe it's B4, B2, and B3. So I got two options. I'm making progress. There's so many more. Doing this by brute force would be horrible. Okay, I'm going to give you the solution. I want you to think about how these have to be together. Those have to be together, do you agree? Now they could slide to different positions, right? So guess what we're going to use? Scrabble tiles. I'm awesome at Scrabble, by the way. I always beat my 11-year-old. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to put all the reds on one Scrabble tile. And the black cards, because they can be anywhere, they're going to go on one Scrabble tile. And then all we're going to do is rearrange Scrabble tiles. Do you remember the question, Regina? Do you remember this one? How many distinct objects do we have? 6. So I can put a box around each Scrabble tile. I'm just rearranging Scrabble tiles. 6 Scrabble tiles. Well, how many Scrabble tiles do I have here? How many Scrabble tiles? 5. You have 5 distinct objects. How do you rearrange 5 distinct objects? 5 factorial. Is that the answer? Am I done? No. what else could change? Does it have to go 1, 2, 3 on those R's? So inside one of the tiles, you have another 3 factorial. So we can multiply those together. 120 times 6, I believe 720, is that right? Social insurance number. You got yours memorized? I know mine memorized. Don't share yours with anybody though. Don't share your social insurance number with anyone. You get identity fraud, right? Okay, so we're going through there. If there are no restrictions on the digits selected for each position, how many social insurance numbers could be created if you can repeat? If you can repeat, this is not permutation. If you're allowed to repeat, it's like that multiple choice question. Remember on the quiz, number 2? How many options on the multiple choice? 4. And then the second question? 4. And then on the third question? 4. So social insurance numbers have how many blanks? 9. And how many digits are available? So it's 10 times 10 times 10. We're going to be here all day. Times 10 times 10. Oh my gosh, we're here all day. There's got to be a better way to do this. Oh, remember it's in the notes, N to the R? Forgot about that. That's 10 to the 9. And then the next one. If no repetition is allowed, okay, this is permutation. This is where it's like, oh, I've used a letter, so I can't use it on the next one. So it would be, okay, I got 10, and then, oh, I've used one. So then the next one has to be 9, and the next one has to be, and so on. Notice how I didn't go all the way to 1. Why is that? There's one less blank, right? This would be 10, P what? 9. Without any calculation, which one's larger? The black or the red? Black's larger, right? Okay. So 10 to the 9, that's billion. Billion. Think there's a billion Canadians? There's like 35 million or something, right? Canadians? There's like a billion people from China, a billion people from India, not a billion in Canada. Ten P9, this has got to be smaller. What's this one? $3,628,000. So even this one wouldn't be enough for all Canadians, would it? So they probably allow you to use any digit. I'm not sure the exact rules. They might have, like, the first digit if you're born in this year. I'm not sure. Okay, so that's it for that lesson. So for some reason it's not here, but quiz, it's 2.3. It's on the other side? Okay, well, we're going to stop there. Quiz 2.3, and then the homework, I'm going to put it up as well. It's the same page as yesterday, but different questions. So let me just put it up for you. Okay, so the homework is page 81, numbers 7 to 10 and 12 to 15. So page 81. It's the same page as yesterday's homework, but different set of questions.